Look at this diagram and this diagram. So whatever the effect takes place, that is shown graphically in this diagram. You are observing in this diagram, this is a bob and this is fixed support and this is string. So one end of the string is fixed at this fixed support and another end is to the bob. Initially, that bob is traversing maximum displacement and which is denoted with a letter A1 at left hand side. When it goes to the right hand side, it will not be at same distance. So less distance it will traverse and that amplitude will be A2. When it will come to this side again, so it is not exactly at this side, so it is at this place. It means continuously with the time amplitude is decreasing. This is A4. Actual position will be here, but it is shifting here. A4, A5, A6, A7, A8, like this. Amplitudes of oscillations of oscillator decreases. This decrement of amplitude of oscillations with the time is shown, and that is damped harmonic oscillations. What is damping? Damping is nothing but the slowing down motion with respect to time. So in this case, how amplitudes are A1, A2, A3, A4, A5, A6, A7, A8 decreasing as time t is increasing. So if the amplitude of oscillations of an oscillator does not remain same, it means it will vary, it will decay with the time, and that oscillator is said to be damped harmonic oscillator, and that motion is called damped harmonic motion. Now the damping is due to effect of friction, and that arises due to the resistance of the medium or internal forces. So any kind of frictional force which opposes motion of the oscillator and it opposes to the velocity of the body, it opposes or it acts on the velocity of the oscillator, we can say. And its magnitude depends on velocity too. So more is the frictional force acting on the particle. The frictional force or damping force, we can say, is proportional to the velocity of the oscillator. This damping force we are writing here minus BV, and another force which is responsible to take that oscillator to its steady position is a restoring force. So both the forces, damping force minus BV and restoring force minus KX, these two forces tries to take oscillator at its steady position, at its mean position. So these two forces equivalent to the another force which we have provided. So according to Newton's second law of motion, m into d2x by dt2 is equal to minus bv minus kx. So this equation you are observing, this suppose equation 1. Further, take this at a left hand side and divide on both sides by m. So we will get this b by m into v plus k by m into x is equal to 0. This is equation suppose 2. Let b divided by m is equal to 1 upon tau and k divided by m is equal to omega square. This is suppose equation 3. d2x by dt2 plus 1 by tau into dx by dt plus omega square x is equal to 0. This is suppose equation 4. We assume that x is equal to a raised to alpha t, and this is equation 5. This equation 5, we are assuming this is solution of this differential equation number 4. This equation is nothing but the solution of this differential equation 4. A and alpha we have to determine. For that, substitute this solution 5 in this equation 4. So we will get a into alpha square into e raised to alpha t plus alpha a divided by tau into e raised to alpha t plus omega square into a raised to alpha t is equal to 0. Everywhere a is common, so a is not equal to 0. Therefore, we don't have to write here a, it will cancel. Alpha square plus alpha by tau plus omega square is equal to 0. So we can denote this equation 6. Equation 6 is quadratic in alpha. Its roots are alpha is equal to minus 1 by 2 tau plus minus under root of 1 by 4 tau square minus omega square is equal to minus 1 upon 2 tau plus minus beta, where beta is equal to under root of 1 by 4 tau square minus omega square. Two roots of alpha are alpha 1 and alpha 2. Alpha 1 is equal to minus 1 by 2 tau plus beta, and alpha 2 is equal to minus 1 by 2 tau minus beta. Substitute values of alpha in equation 6. Whatever the values of alpha are. So x is equal to a1 e raised to minus t divided by 2 tau plus beta t plus a2 into e raised to minus t divided by 2 tau minus beta t, or x is equal to e raised to minus t divided by 2 tau into bracket a1 e raised to beta t plus a2 into e raised to minus beta t. So this is suppose equation 7. Apply initial conditions. Suppose at initial time t is equal to 0, then x is equal to a, that is maximum amplitude traversed by the particle. Dx by dt is equal to 0. On substituting, we get a is equal to a1 plus a2. So differentiating equation 7, we get dx by dt is equal to a1 into bracket minus 1 by 2 tau plus beta into bracket complete into e raised to minus 1 by 2 tau plus beta t plus a2 into bracket minus 1 by 2 tau minus beta bracket complete into e raised to minus 1 by 2 tau minus beta t. Apply initial conditions. At t is equal to 0, dx by dt is equal to 0, then we will get this equation. So from this, or beta into bracket a1 minus a2 is equal to 1 by 2 tau into bracket a1 plus a2 is equal to a divided by 2 tau. So from this, a1 minus a2 is equal to a divided by twice beta tau. So from equation, we know this a is equal to a1 plus a2, and equation this 8, we get a1 is equal to a divided by 2 into bracket 1 plus 1 by twice beta 2. A2 is equal to 1 a by 2 into bracket 1 minus 1 upon twice beta 2. So after substituting in equation 7, we get as x is equal to a by 2 into e raised to minus t divided by 2 tau into bracket 1 plus 1 by twice beta tau into e raised to beta t plus into bracket 1 minus 1 upon twice beta tau into e raised to minus beta e. So this is equation suppose 9. So three different cases arises if case 1 beta is real, means there is a over damping. When damping constant b is so high that 1 upon twice 2 greater than omega, then beta is real, then x is equal to a by 2 into bracket 1 plus 1 upon twice beta 2 into e raised to minus ct plus a by 2 into bracket 1 minus 1 upon twice beta 2 bracket complete into e raised to minus dt, where c is equal to 1 upon 2 tau minus beta and d is equal to 1 upon 2 tau plus beta. So this will be the first case how we got curve x with respect to time t, that is x is displacement of the oscillator of the particle, how it decays with time. Second case, if beta is imaginary, then that case will be under damping. When damping is so small that 1 upon 2 tau less than omega, then beta becomes imaginary. Let beta is equal to I omega dash, then omega dash is given as omega dash is equal to under root of omega square minus 1 upon 4 tau square. Substitute beta is equal to I omega dash in this equation, x is equal to a by 2 into e raised to minus t divided by 2 tau into bracket these terms. After rearranging, we get x is equal to this a divided by 2 into e raised to minus t divided by 2 tau into bracket e raised to I omega dash t plus e raised to minus I omega dash t plus 1 divided by twice I omega dash tau into bracket I omega dash t minus e raised to minus I omega dash t. So from this, x is equal to a divided by 2 into e raised to minus t divided by 2 tau into bracket twice cos omega dash t plus e raised to minus I omega dash t plus 1 upon omega dash tau sin omega dash t. So after that, x is equal to e raised to minus, this is minus, t divided by 2 tau into bracket a cos omega dash t plus e raised to minus I omega dash t plus a divided by twice omega dash tau into sin omega dash t. Here a is equal to suppose a sin phi and a divided by twice omega dash tau is equal to a cos phi. Put these values, then x is equal to a raised to minus t divided by 2 tau into bracket sin phi cos omega dash t plus cos phi into sin omega dash t, or x is equal to this. So this is equation 2. A is equal to a divided by twice omega dash tau into bracket into under root of 1 plus 4 omega dash tau square, and phi is equal to tan inverse of twice omega dash tau. This is suppose equation 3. So we will get frequency 1 upon 2 pi into under root of omega square minus 1 upon 4 tau square is equal to 1 upon 2 pi into under root of k by m minus b square divided by 4 m square. So this will be the second case, how damp oscillations takes place, how amplitude decays exponentially. If critical damping means beta is 0, then what will happen? If 1 upon 2 tau is equal to omega, then beta tends to 0. We know e raised to x is equal to 1 plus x, or e raised to minus x is equal to 1 minus x. Use these. So we will get x is equal to a divided by 2 into e raised to minus t divided by 2 tau into bracket 1 plus beta t plus 1 minus beta t plus 1 upon twice beta tau into bracket 1 plus beta t plus 1 minus beta t. So this will be the x is equal to a divided by 2 into e raised to minus t t divided by 2 tau 1 plus into bracket 1 by 2 tau rx is equal to this. So b is equal to a upon 2 tau. This is suppose equation 1. Here amplitude decays exponentially, amplitude damped oscillations, and this is the third case. So first case is overdamping. This dotted line indicates overdamping, and second this curve, this is for underdamping, and this third curve is critically damped.